He wins the pawn finally. With this long preparation, long preparation of the attack on the queen side. Yes, on the, not just attack. It was not attack really. It was somehow taking space. Really, it was taking space. It was destroying coordination of black pieces. Yes, because black bishop on e6, queen c6 were coordinated with rooks, coordinated defense. So it was king f7, he takes, queen here, rook e2 now, and b5. And now it's one of the great examples of Karpov's calculation, small calculation. It was Capablanca. Because Capablanca, every game he finished with some combination, because he explained that when he is preparing all his positional elements, they come to some, let's say, to some maximal forms, and he is ready to do it. Yes.
Rook takes d7.
Yes. So what? Rook e7. The advantage has to be calculated till
takes
that.
D6.
Yes.
Queen c4.
And queen c4. Variation calculates attack defense. So this, d6, queen c4. Natural move would be rook d4, because unprotected rook. You see, this unprotected rook. Pawn takes e7, rook is unprotected. You see, rook takes d3, unprotected. So if rook d4, but then suddenly unprotected after queen e2 becomes queen. You see, incredible. Pawn takes e7, now queen is unprotected. You see, from the other side. What a defense. But this all nice defense was destroyed, all nice tactical defense was not destroyed with very small move b3. He destroyed it like, and now everything fall down. All his construction fall down, resigned. You see how simple? But what do you see, how big great game, and what is development of the same position, more complicated, modern position, yes, the modern classics. Once more, I want to show you similar position, in modern, modern position and old position. And what is the difference? And it is really difference in handling both positions. And how beautifully and how nice Karpov did it perform, yes? And how simple. And is his construction this? He used many elements, even this Alekhine battery he used, which was very, very strong, let's say, element in the attack. So, once more, it's generally plan is the attack of the weakness. Sometimes weakness we can see, but in many cases we have to prepare. To prepare weakness, it helps us, let's say, knowledge of the typical plans. Every opening, every structure has its typical plans. Without knowledge of typical plans, it's practically impossible to, let's say, to play in modern chess. Because this knowledge of typical plans is in many cases automatical.
Sorry, what if I am black and I'm on defensive, for instance? Can I make a plan?
So no, just a second. What you want to say? Which position? In normal position? Position.
My opponent is as smart as Karpov, and he doesn't have weaknesses at all.
At all, yes. You see, it's very. Yes, once more. Chess is very. There are general rules, but these general rules are always used in the concrete situations. Yes, in one situation you can use this rule, in another use this rule. I will show you, for example, later. I will show you very useful. Okay, maybe I will start it now. I will show you, for example. So-called, there are situations in when it is very difficult to find the move. It's very difficult to find the move sometimes for juniors. It is even, but there are some certain positions when there are some simple rules which are useful. For example, such rule is you rule of the worst piece or rule of the macogon. Yes, this rule says if there is no tactics in the position and you don't see how to improve your position, find the worst piece and improve it or exchange it. You see, the same in defense. If you don't see the plan, if you don't know what to do, find the worst piece or find your biggest weakness and try to improve it. Sometimes possible, sometimes not, you see. It's life. Sometimes possible, sometimes not. So I will show you, for example, this this kind of stuff. It is here, which is very, very, very useful rule for young players, which in many situations they cannot find a real plan. Makugono rule, yes. So, yes, this. So, Galiamovo Prokopchuk, okay, so some game, not so important. White is attacking. White opened h-file, forced, sacrificed the pawn. But this attack is a bit, let's say, not successful yet. Queen h7, king f8, what to do? Rook f1, but what is the real plan? But let us start to think as this rule of the worst piece. What is white's worst piece? Bishop on c1, where to put it?
d5 or
d6? Immediately, you see, such move comes immediately. You see, such move comes immediately, but when experienced player, he has a knowledge of this rule, yes? Juniors and beginners, they don't have this knowledge. Find the worst piece always. They will start to think about different things. If you think about worst piece, you immediately come to this. He plays the defense this, stops bishop d6, we play bishop e5, and he plays queen h7 is a threat, king f8, only defense. Now, but Makugono rule, or rule of the worst piece, is not used just once time. It can be used 10 times in the game. Can be used 10 times. Why 10 times? Because one, you put one piece, another piece now started to be, let's say, looking into the cellar. What I'm doing here? Which piece is doing like this?
E1.
Oh, you see, it's doing nothing. So what to do with it? You see? Just exactly. No. Well, what is this? Something wrong. No. King f8. No, yes, queen h7, rook e1 was correct. After rook e1, knight e5, rook takes e5 and mate. Yes, so funny, so simple. But she didn't play second time, she played rook queen h7, opponent played knight e5, and she played queen e5, and here opponent made mistake, yes? Made terrible mistake, because it made tactical mistake. It was possible to let's say, not to survive, I say, but to get good chances for survival after what? After useful queen h6, yes? Which is always useful, always possible, always after queen g6. Queen g6, transferring, sacrificing pawn back, rook and game, black would have some chances to survive, for sure. Maybe, okay, white is still better, but okay. It's rooks and game, yes? Or king g8 first and then rook e6. So there are different chances to survive. Maybe even here king g8 is possible, yes? If rook goes back, then rook g6, yeah? So rook and game always promise chances, yes? Always promise chances. Maybe, but white is still somewhat slightly better, but black is fighting on the good way to make draw. But black decided that it's possible, is no danger to take the pawn. Because queen h8 attack doesn't work because of queen e7, rook e1. He, you know, calculation was of black was very funny, like this. He plays this move, rook takes, rook take e5, now king d6. And both rook are hanging. So he was happy, yes? But he overlooked very simple thing, yes, of course. This. He overlooked very simple thing. What he overlooked?
Rook
he overlooked rook h1, and after queen takes e1, he overlooked intermediate check. And the coordination of pieces was destroyed, you see? Then he got, of course, rook e1 check. So, it's a simple example. But this example shows, okay, such examples, which I show you first, small, is simpler, show like for this, for... Not beginners, but for players of the second year. But let's say, for example, more complicated case. Yeah, just a second. What is this? Why is this? Yes. So, it's Korsunov Spassky, yeah? White is quite comfortable, yes? Quite comfortable. white is better. Okay, better. Black has some holes in the position. E6 is a hole. White has bishop pair, but black sometimes somehow these two knights are keeping some balance. Yes, keeping some balance. It's very difficult to say if it is sufficient or not, but keeping. But what to do now? To play rook e6, what is the concrete plan, concrete improvement? Tactics, there is no tactics. Concrete improvement is very difficult, yes? Concrete improvement. Rook e6 or what after? Rook e6. Not so clear. But let us think about in the way of the worst piece. What is the worst piece in the position? Yes, please.
Maybe the knight. Maybe he's not doing
bishop. Which bishop?
Light square.
Yes, correct. Bishop is not so strong, but we have to speak about reality. Yes? What really? It would be nice to move bishop to e6, yes? But is it realistic? Very difficult, yes? Bishop is not strong, but we cannot do with it anything. Knight c3, we can play this knight?
If on e6, it would be
nice. Look. Black's strongest pieces, black has two strong pieces, knight d6 and bishop f6, which cements the position, yes? So where it would be useful to put the knight from c3, which is doing nothing, yes? It stays not badly, but doing nothing. Where to put this knight?
e5.
On e5, knight e2, c1, d3.
Long way.
Long way, e5, interesting. But is it realistic? What black plays after knight e2? Black will play c4 immediately, yes? And knight c1, you will be very late.
Maybe then after c4, we can put knight d4.
Yes, yeah, we can put it on d, but very good square is h5, yes? Interesting, tempting. Knight comes to h5, take on f6, and the e file is open, and we will kill on this e file, yes? So, how we will do it? So, he plays knight e2. He goes to h5. Because h5 is direct. Knight on e5 is a nice place, but if you compare what is the more effective on e5 or on h5, what
closer
we can say?
King, only h5 is closer to...
closer to the king, closer to the action. Concrete action. Yes, concrete action, yes? So, black plays this. First, pawn was c5. Now we change our route, knight d4 and knight g3. Now we forced opponent to open our window. Yes?
Both looks tempting. Maybe I would prefer knight d4 more straightforward.
Knight d4. Let's see. Interesting, yes, it's tempting. Always knight d4 is terribly tempting. But let us calculate. He played knight g3, if he played knight d4, he takes on b3, queen takes, yes. Queen comes to c4, knight comes to e6, and rook came to c8. And suddenly, what we achieved with our knight on e6?
Not too much.
Because knight on e6 is very nice, you know, like ballerina. Usually, statistically, if we say knight comes to e6, in 95% it is winning, yes. It's winning because it's something doing some terrible harm to all positions. But there are some positions, I told you, there are rules in chess, statistically, generally, because they are in 90% cases, they are working in 10 not. This is like ballerina, yes? Beautifully placed, yes? Stays. But what is doing?
Blocking down guys
because of this. Because in many cases in such a situation, it's necessary to put knight back to open rook file for the rook and then once more to come back, you know? It's typical. So it's one of the cases where knight on e6 looks beautiful, but not effective at all because there is no threat, no use from this knight. So he plays knight g3 for this reason. Pawn takes, queen c4, knight h5, take on b3, take on b3. Now threat is knight e6, f6 and rook e7, he plays knight c8, yes? Take and pawn takes. Now we can use, we play rook e6 and threat is bishop c5 in b6. Now, of course, we can use once more rule of the worst piece. Which piece now is the worst?
Oh,
it has some function. Oh, it protects e4. Or not. But which piece is doing absolutely nothing?
Rook on
d1. Where to place it?
On c1.
On c1. He wants to rook c7. He plays this. Rook c6. You see? Immediately improving. Without thinking. Because it's a process of improvement of the position. Yes, now this, now this. Now, what is weakest piece? King or bishop? You see, all pieces, three pieces we improved, yes? Which piece? Or bishop? Let us, which piece we can improve?
Because the rook is on d7, but the king is doing nothing.
So, no, we can try to improve bishop to attack knight, yes, to play bishop e2, but we must, okay, check with the finger. Knight e4, bishop a6, and knight d6. And what we did?
We improved opponent's
pieces, you see, suddenly. We improved both. So say, no, go back. Now we can improve king, g3, and king goes here, king goes forward. And okay, Spassky decided to die like a man. He decided to use last chance for the mating trap. If opponent take on h4, last chance, who knows, who knows what happened. But after pawn takes, knight e4, he took, and bishop f6, and it was time to resign. You see, so simple. But let's tell this, sometimes we have to calculate something. It was not so much to calculate in this game, not so much except knight d4, knight e6, yes? Calculating to evaluate, yes? It was calculation with evaluation. We play two moves with knight, and then we realize that this knight is doing nothing. Then we play simple moves like knight g3, and we don't need to calculate anything, yes? You see, there are some games in which it's not necessary to calculate. Simple. Improve, and improve, yes?
Many Karpov games.
Karpov, Botvinnik sometimes,
Positional thinking, isn't it? Attack.
Yes, it is position for, let's say, for some logical thinking. It's not for calculation, I play this, he plays this. Yes, it's position for, let's say,
understanding.
Yes, understanding how to place pieces, yes? And so it's, for this is instructive, yes? Instructive for, let's say, for juniors to explain them what to do. Okay, there are many. This rule is very useful. For example, I show there are simple cases, and I will show you complicated case. There are simple cases. It's okay. Gligorich played against Spielman. It was very interesting line, b6. Fischer loved this variation very much. He played few games against Portish, against somebody else. It was one of his favorite lines. Bishop a3, take, sacrificing a pawn, something like this. H5, H4, knight c6, he played e4, long castle, yes? It was this position, yeah? I think this, so. Funny. Let us look objectively on the position. It's quite complicated strategically because it's unbalanced, yes? Unbalanced, there is no structures which are one against, structures are not pawns one against another. Pieces are a bit different. King, white king is a bit in question, yes? What to do, where to go? To go, let's say, to one side, to castle long, it would be a bit risky, yes? Castle short, okay, maybe someday g5, yes? So, how otherwise improve position? Not so clear what to do, yes? Not so clear, not clear plan. E5, knight d5, knight a5.
Bishop
c5. Bishop? C5. You want the opponent's takes, but who will take you on c5? It's interesting, bishop c5. To try to open b file, yes, okay. It is provocation, yes, we can say. It is. But let us say he plays something, maybe knight here, maybe here, maybe king b7 first. Then maybe even maybe e5 later, knight a5. Something wrong. Yeah. Not. We don't understand what's going on. Yes, a bit. But let us think then logically. Let's return back and think what our pieces are doing. Queen c4 is well placed. Knight g3 is doing something. It attacks a5, protects e4. Rooks, we don't know how we will castle, but which piece is doing nothing?
Bishop
is doing nothing. Look, he's open, yes? But he's absolutely empty. This bishop is absolutely empty. It's just like
shooting in the
air, yes? But there is nothing in the air. Shooting, poof. Who cares? What is this? Just function. I show that I am. Yes, I show. I show that I exist. So what to do with it? Transfer where? To G5. Immediately, just like this, and this. Immediately, transfer to G5, so fast. And on G5, you see immediately, these guys will do something, yes? On G5, this guy will create terrible threats. Then it will be not clear for black how to save. You see, in two moves, threats have to get absolutely winning position. Absolutely winning, let's say, winning power of the on the king side, yeah? So, as I can imagine how was Spielman looking, how much time he was thinking, what to do here, what's happened? Suddenly he was quite, okay, here maybe he made mistake. He was very, let's say, probably safe. He was thinking, oh, it is easy job, I will do something. He could play maybe knight e8, trying f5, maybe trying to sacrifice the pawn, maybe something, or knight g4 first, knight f6, just somehow, let's say, provoking f3. But he wanted, okay, king b8 is useful. King b8 is useful. And suddenly he gets bishop c1. And suddenly terrible threat. In one moment, seems to be bishop, okay, on a3, look, bishop on a3, but on this diagonal, it is a piece, yes?
Now it's too late for g6.
It's too late for everything suddenly, you see?
Or
suddenly,
after
some move, bishop c1, you know, we say always go forward, yes, we play attacking chess forward, but sometimes it's move back, yes? Knight g4, f3, and he decided to sacrifice. To make mess on the board, yes? Knight e5, threatening knight d3, check, rook, double rook, c5, c4. Now realization of this piece was very difficult, but Gligorich showed fantastic technique. So you see, he played this, knight d3, king f1, queen e5. And he starts, okay, ugly move. He plays ugly move. He puts pieces back, you see? Now he takes, and he plays g3, and he puts all pieces back. You see, technique is incredible. He improves first defense and then he improves slowly. Every piece. Rook d3, he improves. Here, he improves. See, suddenly all pieces are like all together, yeah? So this technique is really terrible. Now it's time to exchange, yes? Rook d4, rook d2, exchange of one rook. Queen a5, take, back. Now rook b3. Trying to exchange. Control second rank, rook c2 is a threat. He stops it, and rook d2. And knight e3. You see, suddenly all pieces came out. And queen a4, knight d1. Stopping it, and e5. And here he played this, knight f3. Incredible knight. Incredible power of Gligorich. Queen e4, and black resigned. You see? Incredible defense, yes? Not defense, improvement. Improvement of every piece, slowly defending and then improving. It's one of the, let's say, examples how it's necessary to improve under attack, yes? Under attack and to realize this piece. Now I'll show you my game about complicated case of this, complicated case, yes. So I played against Bareev. Many years ago, 1990, can you imagine? So, it was French favorite variation of Bareyev. He played very successfully. I can't say Zaev was not satisfied with the position. I improved everything, every piece. And I tried to think how I can improve, because I believe my pieces are more active. Every my piece practically is better, except maybe knight d6 and knight b3. Knight d6 is quite strong, yeah. My queen is a bit better placed, yes. Rook d1, okay, rook d1, d1 is a bit active because it's attacking pawn d5, yeah. His rook, knight f6 is okay. Either doing something. But now I have to do something. What to do? Now, my plan. My plan was to attack d5, of course, yes? Plan was, weakness was on d5. You can do what you want, there is no other weakness. To create another weakness is not the time yet, yes? But where? Who knows? So, I tried to come knight d4, knight f5, yes? Trying knight d4, it doesn't work. Bishop f6 does not work, yes? If I play bishop f6, he takes, I take here, he can take even with the rook, I will win a pawn, but he will play knight c4 and he will win this pawn b2, then pawn c2 is under attack. And what are my two knights are doing? I was very short calculation. I tried this move, everything goes wrong. Then I tried to find the worst piece. Something is wrong, but I can't find the move. So then reaction is normal to find the worst piece. Where is the worst piece? Started to think. Of course, probably knight b3, yes? But what to do with this knight? Yes, the worst piece. Where to place it?
F4.
Yeah. Where?
Maybe somewhere on f4 or something?
Knight on f4. Oh, it would be possible, but how I put it knight from d3 to f4?
C1,
e2. E2. But maybe he will place knight c1, queen c4.
On knight c4. Maybe to kill that knight on d6, because it's coming to c4 at some point.
But I decided that this knight has to go to e3. But I couldn't play this move. Why? I was thinking for 15 minutes. That why I couldn't play knight d2? Because I played knight b3 three moves before. Or four moves before. You know, like in French, they play knight b3, knight f3, bishop comes to e3, and I played four or five moves before. And I prepared, was ready to come with knight to d4, yes? You see, it was thinking, okay, knight on d4, it's my dream. But then I realized that on d4, every piece is well placed, yes? And this knight on b3 is out of system somewhere. What to do with it? And I decided that I have to place it on e3. He started to attack, I played bishop d4. Now knight f1, knight e3, and attack on d5. Very simple like that. So I found only place for the knight from b3, improving it. He played this, I played queen b5, started some tactics, this and knight e6. I played, now c2 is hanging and knight d4. So bishop c3 is stupid, d4 I will get, so I play attack. Attack, counter attack. He plays this, I play this move, and he plays knight f4. He decided for activization and preparation of queen g4. I play knight f1 and he plays queen g4. Solid activization, maybe some knight e4 later, so I started to not be nervous, but I saw that knight h3 is possible, some check knight h3 I didn't like, so I decided, okay, I will stop you here. I will stop you with knight g3. He plays bishop f8, I took it. So, okay, exchange one pair of rook, and now I started to think what to do, yes? What to do, what is my worst piece, yes? Of course, my worst piece at the moment is, which piece is doing nothing?
Bishop.
Knight, bishop, yes? Where to place it?
E3.
E3, correct. E3 goes back into defense and prepare some queen b4, you see? Preparing some queen b4, then exchanging, yes? Exchanging queens and d5, we will talk about d5 later. So he plays knight f6. And here I played queen c7. Bronstein used to say, chess is a game of double attack, yes? Because all these great guys, they had own saying. Fischer used to say chess is timing, that it's necessary to make everything as fast as possible. It's true. And Bronstein used to say chess is a game of double attack. Why? Because at the end, everything is decided by double attack. He used to say everything. Yes, because opponent cannot protect both. Everything is dead. So you see, I'm attacking b7 and I'm looking on f4 with one eye, yes? Rentgen. Because if he plays rook e6, then I'm ready to kill, yes? But sometimes there are moves with two ideas, but there are cases, there are moves with three ideas, sometimes. And if move is with three ideas, then move is terribly strong, you know? So this move was move with the three ideas. And I attack on b7, he automatically played here, and he got suddenly queen sacrifices. But real problem was not double attack. Real problem is unprotected knight, you see, at the end. Knight on f4, as I told you. It was real reason. Okay, he lost the game after a few moves like this. But I was calculating more knight g2, yes? But I have here this bit, yes? Bishop takes, knight takes, and bishop takes, yes? Extra pawn and easily winning situation. But you see, this was the case after queen c7. There is triple attack. Not really triple attack. It's attack on b7, f7, and looking on f4, you know? Not allowing rook e6. So still, you see, this Bronstein, chess is a game of double attack, is really something, let's say, something not just valuable, but it's extremely, extremely important, yes.
I saw this game, for 3 years ago, I saw somewhere was explained that this game.
Maybe I was playing on DVD, yes, chess base, yes.
Now, but
Yeah. No. So what is all about to conclude it? So you see, there are rules, some rules of the worst piece, which is very, very useful rule, very especially for young players, because in many cases they ask trainer, what I have to play here, what I have to do, because there is no clear attack, no clear plan. Sometimes there are situations when there is no clear attack for yes, please.
For beginner, when I teach beginner, I also say them first to go the forcing moves, and if they don't have a good forcing moves, they should improve the worst piece.
The worst piece,
and
yeah.
This is very easy concept for them, yeah, to think. Let's say some kid is playing human's chess.
Yeah.
It's very easy to remember.
Yeah.
And they are doing quite well after.
This rule once more is working just in the situation when there is no tactics, when there are no direct attacks, direct threats,
yes,
for you. In such case, when there are no direct tactics, any tactics in the position, any possible logical improvements, then it's always necessary to think like that. It's useful. It's practical rule. Yes, practical rule which can be used in any situation. So okay, let's make a break. 15
okay.
Minutes.
So quarter after 5 o'clock here.
Yeah.
Эту технику мы оставляем.
Mm-hmm. Хорошо.
Because of duplicate, yeah, good. 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 Yeah, good.